Hello there and welcome back to this video series on programming for problem solving using C language. After watching this video, you will be able to use printf function with understanding. So far we have been seeing printf in several example programs, but we didn't exactly see what is the syntax and the flexibility that printf offers. We will see that C language does not have a printf built into it. The C language itself cannot interact with input devices or output devices. So if you want to send some characters to an output device, you have to use printf. This printf is defined in stdio.h header, S standard input output header. That is the reason why you need to include this header when you use printf or its counterpart scanf. The prototype of this function printf is also given in stdio.h. Okay, and further we see that the return type of printf is integer. When you say return type is the type of the value that a function computes. So printf computes an integer value, and this integer is precisely the number of characters printed on the screen when we use a printf statement. So printf does two things. One, it prints the requested characters, and two, it counts how many characters are printed. Okay. With this, we'll try to see the syntax of printf statement. Printf statement takes two arguments. One is format, second is list. This list will contain a comma separated list of constants or variables or function calls or expressions. That is in general the beauty of C language. Wherever you use constants, you can use any one of these variables, functions and expressions. Or wherever you use an expression, in that place you can put any one of these. We will see more about it at a later date. Similarly, the format is a string constant or a string variable or a function call that returns a string or an expression that evaluates to a string. This becomes familiar and clear when we see a few code snippets. Use that code snippets in a program to understand clearly what they mean. With that, we'll see the first example. In this example, you have a printf statement and you have two items in the list, 123 and 34.56. Correspondingly, there are two things here, %d and %f. This %d corresponds to the first item in the list, %f corresponds to the second item in the list. Okay. In this example, two values will be printed, 123 and 34.56. That is the comma separated list. And we see that there is a %d and %f, and this %d and %f, they are called format specifiers. So we see that for each item in the list, there must be one format specifier. Similarly, for each format specifier, there must be one item in the list. Let us look at another example. You have A is equal to %d, B is equal to %f, and A and B. This A and B are variables that are separated by comma. So this is a comma separated list. Corresponding to each one of these, you have %d and %f. A is an integer variable, so you use a %d. B is a floating point variable, so you use %f. The first variable is A, second variable is B. So we use corresponding format specifications. Other than this %d and %f, whatever characters are there, they are exactly printed as it is. So it will print A is equal to and value of A, B is equal to and value of B. Let us look at third example. In the third example, you have again a comma separated list of items A, A plus B and character constant C. Because there are three items here, there must be three format specifications, %d, %f and %c. Other than these percents, all the characters are printed exactly as they are. Here %c is a format specification for character constants. Okay, this is another example that shows that we can include a function call within a printf statement. Try to run this program and see what is the output, and try to see if it makes sense to you. We will see one more programming example and wind up this video. Carefully notice we have included a map.h here. This map.h is a header that contains the definition of sine a, cos a, and so on, several other functions. Okay, let us see the last example. The last example is given here. It is just two statements, one a definition, second a function call. Watch the previous portion of this video once again, that is, watch the portion from the beginning till this point, then pause the video. Study the program given below very carefully, then run this program to see the output. It is very instructive. You can see there is a printf statement within a printf statement. Okay, that's all we have for now. Have a great day.